Hello, rock people. This is Dave the Geology Dude. This is a patch of ripple marks on Alki Beach in Seattle. It covers an area of roughly 20 square meters, or about 200 square feet. There are two general types of ripple marks, symmetrical and asymmetrical. I'm just going to show you symmetrical ripples today. Waves on beaches like this produce mostly symmetrical ripples. The ripples are formed from two different directions of energy. The first direction is the water that flows up onto the beach. The second direction is in the opposite direction, where the water that washed onto the beach thereafter flows back down to the base level of the water. These occur along lakes, oceans, and occasionally along eddies near the sides of rivers. The energy of the moving water carries sand with it. On a beach, it typically moves back and forth. Each ripple mark that forms will have a highland crest area followed by a lowland trough. With symmetrical ripples, the distance between the crest and the trough are roughly equal on both sides of the crest. Not shown here today are asymmetrical ripples. These form when sand is moved by only one direction of energy. One example is water flowing downhill in a stream or river. Wind can also move sand to form ripples, such as on a dune. This also is in one direction. However, asymmetrical ripples do not have equal distances on both sides of the crest to the trough. On one side of the crest, the sand ramps up gradually, but on the opposite side of the ripple, the slope goes down quite steeply from the crest. It is fun to see rocks where ripple marks have been lithified and preserved. It is especially interesting when layers of rocks later become tilted at a steep angle by processes of folding and faulting. In the Cascade Mountains near Seattle, I know a place where 40-million-year-old ripple marks are tilted at about a 70-degree angle. Obviously, ripple marks don't form at such steep angles. But at this place, I can look at the ripples and see that they are symmetrical ripples, similar to these on the beach today. Then I can lean onto these tilted ripples of this rock and think what it would have been like to lay on this beach when it formed 40 million years ago. That is so totally cool.